First half was obviously hard with the wind, but going a goal up, and then they did have a couple of chances, but so did we, maybe to go further in front. When we came in at half time, I was always confident we'd go in and win the game, because having that wind in the second half, and I thought the boys really grew into the game. It's a confidence thing with us at the moment. We lost a couple of bad goals last week, but we told them during the week that didn't make a difference. They still won the game. 87 minutes, they were brilliant. A wee bit anxious for the last 3 or 4 minutes of that game, but we managed to hold out today and win quite comfortably in the end, which is pleasing.
Good spread of goals as well across the team, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. To be fair, we have got goals in our team. We're dangerous from set pieces as well, something that we've worked on. It's pleasing.
Quality to get your first win on the road, well, first points on the road. 3-0, boom, easy, on the road.
To be honest, I felt like it's been coming. I felt like when we've been away from home, we've been 2-0 down after 10 minutes. And it really does not. The boys have had been knocked a lot this season, and through suspensions of our own doing, don't get me wrong, but suspensions, injuries, we've not really been able to get a settled side on the park. And I think the boys are starting to get there now, and we're starting to build a wee bit of consistency, both performance wise and team selection.
Also, it builds confidence going forward, doesn't it? Because
you're
having momentum
at that point. Yeah, it does. It shows the boys that they're capable. I think they always knew that. I mean, I think we brought in a lot of new players, and it does take time, but we do feel that we are a good enough side. But it was just getting that confidence back after the difficult start, really.
A clean sheet as well. Like you say, 3 points on the road, clean sheet, three different scorers, perfect day.
Our last 5 minutes, that was the aim, to keep a clean sheet, I can assure you. So it gives them confidence. But I thought they were excellent. And to be honest, they have been excellent for the start of the season and training. And I said that to the chairman before the game. I said if we were going on training, they would be a great team, because they really do work hard, and we've just not been getting the results. And I'm delighted for the boys today. I mean, it was all them, and they were really excellent.
6-0 up at half time.
Well, that's what I mean. It's like a broken down gramophone record. I mean, it's unbelievable that, as I said to the players, you don't take your chances. And it's happening. It seems to be at home. It seems to be happening more than not, you know. But our away form seems to be far different from a home form, which is something about to be fixed, you know. So it seems to be a bit of a confidence thing, but as I say, we don't take our chances. We should be comfortably sitting at 3-1 up half time. We need one chance, I said, for a corner kick and score from it, but other than that, probably a shot, and we've got, it's not even just half chances, it's 3-4 ones in the 6-yard box that really have to be in the net. Big Mark McGinn's got a 1-1, the keeper's got to be a goal, so that's the biggest problem at the moment. And then it gives teams a lift. They get the goal ahead, and then, as I say, that goal gives them that extra yard, extra bit of something to hold on to, and that seems to be what's happening at the moment. So very disappointed.
I'm sure it's a frustrating thing, because you are creating chances, just not taking them.
That's what I mean. See, when you are creating chances, that's when you've got to really put them in the net. Because I'm sure we would have been standing here talking about a totally different game if at least one of the chances went in, you know. But to miss, as I say, at least 3-4, not even half chances, they're gilt edged. And they should be in the net, you know, so it's very disappointing that we haven't managed to get that goal. And as I say, in the second half, we looked a wee bit inept and a wee bit back on our heels, you know. Like, as I say, it's a confidence thing. It doesn't look like we were going to score second half, apart from Mikel's got a shot, Mikel Turner, we're only shot in goal second half, you know. But it seems to be the stuff when we knocked out was after the first half, and yet we spoke about half time that on a goal down, we need to lift ourselves up, and you know, but so very disappointed, but. So we need to pick ourselves up.
Was that the message at half time, just sort of keep going? Because if you created 6 chances in the first half, you must think, right, keep going, and eventually one of them must go in.
Yeah, don't get me wrong, the conditions was obviously quite a strong wind behind us, you know, but you've got to take advantage of that, you know. To go a goal down with the wind at our backs is obviously very disappointing. But as I say, I never foresaw that coming. But I mean, as I say, you can see Cowan Beath with the energy and the legs they got, the confidence they get from what a goal does to you, and it's the same at any level. Goals will change games and change the whole complexion of it, you know. If we'd got that goal, it would have gave us a bit more confidence, a bit more belief in ourselves, you know. But as I say, we don't seem to be having that belief, because we're not scoring enough goals at the moment, you know. So, and it mounts a lot of pressure on the whole team, defensively and everything else. So it's something we've got to improve on.
Two goals at home in the league all season, it's
well, that explains everything. That's exactly what I'm talking about, you know. It's our home form has been very, very poor and more erratic than anything, you know. And it's a strange one, because I don't know where they're getting the pressure on themselves from, you know. So we should be making this place a very, very difficult place to come. But at the moment, it's we're gifting teams an early goal, and then we're making an uphill battle for ourselves. And the way we're going, we just don't seem to have that confidence to put the ball in the net at home, which is something we have to, as I say, dramatically improve on.
Were there any positives today?
Well, I'd be more worried if we never created any chances.
That's,
you know,
true.
But, it's, but again, I need to keep saying that, you know, it's like the chances we do create are, they have to be a goal, it's have to be a goal. So
yeah.
I pull my hair out and say, you know, it's like unbelievable, what can you do as a manager? You're saying it's got to be in the net. It's not like we don't work on things like that in training, getting men into the box and getting shots on target. I even spoke about before the game that we have to have that wee bit of composure in front of goal to get over the ball and at least make the goalkeeper save it, you know. But as I say, we don't seem to take that into the games at the moment, certainly at home, and as I said, we have to improve that big time.
I suppose the good news is you're away from home next week because you're doing all right away from
home.
Well,
we seem to be at the moment, you know, but as I say, it's disappointing that we don't get the home form right, you know, but that's something we have to certainly improve on. We need to keep working hard at it and get the confidence and belief back here, certainly at Stair Park. So, as I say, we're away at Ayr United, which is certainly going to be a very tough game for us. I mean, they're flying high and I think they won again today, so we're expecting a very, very hard game up there, you know, but I wouldn't be surprised if we got there and get a result the way we've been playing away from home. But as I say, we're looking for a big, big improvement in terms of certainly the second half. I don't think there was much wrong first half, except we never took our chances.
And no shortage of motivation for, well, and yourself, but the players in the dressing room as well, a lot of them were at Ayr United.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, that's all history now. I don't really think too much of that. You know, I'm just more looking to try and get the points for Stranraer and go and get the result. But as I say, we're expecting a very, very hard game. And if we don't take our chances and perform in the right way and defend properly, then we could be on the end of a defeat. So that's something we need to pick ourselves up, work hard this week in training, and go and look forward to a big game at Somerset.
Coming in here, it must feel a wee bit like groundhog day at times that you're coming in.
Well, it seems to be, you know, I said that to the players in there, we can't keep talking about it, doing this and doing that, you know. So it comes a stage that we need to be freshen up and bring somebody in that's going to put the ball in the net, because we can't keep saying the same things. But I mean, I'm loyal to the boys, and hopefully they can get that confidence. We've got good players in there that are just low in confidence at home, and as I say, we need to pick ourselves up and stop feeling sorry for ourselves, you know. So as I say, the bonus is at least we're creating chances, but as I say, it's so frustrating as a manager, and I'm sure for the support as well, that you're seeing chance after chance go a begging, and as I say, one of them goes in, it's a totally different game altogether. You'd see a totally different team, one playing with a bit of confidence on the front foot and working hard, you know. But as I say, the stuff seems to have been knocked out of them, and it knocks up to me to try and make sure I pick them up and get them going again.
Okay.